Hello everybody, another thrift store video coming your way, and this is exceptional. We found some really good stuff for the store and some better stuff for our own collections. Amanda and I were out, both of us, a bit yesterday, so it's a combination of what we both found, because she worked a shorter shift yesterday, got off a little bit earlier, and I couldn't come home during the middle of the day to get any work done on eBay and anything like that, because they were doing some paving at the end of the street in our neighborhood, and where we live, it's, you know, a dead end on the one side, so you actually couldn't, for like hours of the day, get to your house. So we were out and found all kinds of stuff, and I'll start with the coolest things for our collection, because I'm just very excited, because they are things that we have in other forms, but these are very specific Star Trek things, like, that we really, really wanted. And for starters, Star Trek The Next Generation, I've always wanted those big silver box sets when the series first started coming to DVD, and I just never owned those. Always watched things on VHS and had different, you know, DVD releases as they came out, with a whole series of Blu-ray and Laserdisc and whatever. They are getting harder to find now and are really expensive, so very, very happy whenever we find one of those, because we want a complete set of all seven seasons. And I found yesterday seasons 5 and 6. Very, very exciting. These are really cool box sets. These are my favorite design as far as the TNG releases. Open up and then pull it out. It's a nice box set. I love these older style DVD cases. They take up more room, but I enjoy these big fold-out ones. I have the Anchor Bay sets for Xena and Hercules and a bunch of different shows, Buffy, whatever. I just love, look, they keep folding out and keep folding out, and see if I can do this nicely, because it gets so long at the end there, but they just, like, keep going and going. I love these big fold-out ones. They always have nice artwork, and they always have, I feel like, better designs on the actual discs. I feel like a lot of times when some of these older shows got reprinted for later DVD sets, the designs on the actual discs became more generic. Like the Hercules and Xena, each disc has a unique picture from one of the episodes featured on that disc. That's the top of the disc, that's the image on it, and now it's just a generic, this is Hercules Legendary Journeys and some little colors, like it's just a blank disc. But yeah, so season 5 and 6 of TNG. That was fantastic. Really happy to add those particular versions. And the two-disc widescreen collection, the Special Collector's Edition of Star Trek III, The Search for Spock. And now we almost have this complete setup here, this complete line. We're now only missing Star Trek's 4 and 5, because we had 1 and 2 and 6 and all the TNG movies in this particular set, collection that they released. And now we have 3, so we're just missing 2 of them to have a complete set, and I like the way these look on the shelf, even though Star Trek The Motion Picture is the only one that's not the silver color, it's a gold, so it kind of stands out, but otherwise, like, they just look like a cool set of all the Star Trek movies, and they're really have tons of great special features. A lot of these have moved on to different DVD releases or Blu-ray, some of them have not with the special features, but yeah, just really, really good collection. So I'm very happy that we almost have a complete set of that. And the last thing for Star Trek is something from the Smithsonian Channel, a documentary, Building Star Trek, a new documentary about a series ahead of its time. So that is one of the documentaries that we did not own for Star Trek. It was good to add that to the collection. And on a somewhat related note, we're getting closer to finishing our collection of StarGate. We finished Atlantis, so I have all the releases that we want for Atlantis, and we're getting close with SG-1. Now we have the newer slim case release of SG-1 Complete Season 10, the Farscape Invasion. So we have that release, and Season 10 is the one that we did not own at all. Most of the other seasons we have the old big cases with the individual releases, where it's like 5 of these for each season in a big box set, and some of them we have the slim, and we have, you know, going for 2 complete sets, one the big box sets and one the slim. And season 10, somehow we just haven't found either version, because now we have at least a copy of every season. So we're getting close to being done with StarGate as well, so that'll eventually be a video when that happens in the future. And then moving on, a couple more things on the DVD front. Amanda found this Hobbit motion picture trilogy set, and this is great because then we can get rid of the individual releases, so it takes up the room of 1 on the shelf instead of 3, which is always a good thing when you have a larger movie collection. to do that, especially for movies like the Hobbit movies, which you enjoy, but they're not anywhere near your favorites, so you really don't want them taking up a lot of room. Like the Lord of the Rings, it's an exception. We have like a lot of different versions of that. Hobbit movies, not as much. And then this sealed copy of The Mary Tyler Moore Show, the complete second season. And this is going to be great. This I will actually be keeping as well, because my season two is a different release than my other seasons. I all have this same, the newer, slim case release. My season two, though, is the older, slightly bigger box set release that has three little cases that come out. So this will be more matching for my set. So I'll put my old set on the store and keep that. And then the last thing here, I believe, looking around, that's the last thing that might be for us, and the rest is all for the store. Everything else here, I found two Wii U games, and one depends how much I like it, we might end up keeping it, because I like the Wii U, and this game, I remember even from the previews, looked really good, so I'll try it out, and if I like it, we'll end up keeping it. If not, it'll end up on the store. But Yoshi's Woolly World for the Wii U. I like the Wii U, still hooked up in the bedroom. It's kind of turned into my Xenoblade Chronicles X machine, as most of my other favorite games have been ported to the Switch, and I also own them on the Switch. This is not, of course, there's now Yoshi's Crafted World on the Switch, but this looked a little more interesting to me artistically, with the woolly, like the fabric feel versus the Crafted World, which it looks cool, and I played the demo and I enjoyed it, but this looks a little more up my alley, so we probably will end up keeping that for the Wii U. And then we found a copy of Smash Brothers for the Wii U that will be going up on the store in a little while. We want to get it for the Switch. I mean, neither of us are really big Smash fans, but we just kind of want one version of Smash, and we're going to end up, of course, then if we're only going to have one, we're going to go with the one on the Switch. So this will end up on the store, but we'll have fun at least testing that out, playing it for an hour or two. And then the rest is everything for the store. Found a good variety of things. Let me move this box out of the way. I also bought new shoes yesterday when I was out. I really needed new sneakers. I just kept putting that off. And anytime it's clothing shopping, I just like wait till the last minute. A couple things for the store. We had this big box set of Frank Miller's Sin City. And this Ultimate Cut Watchmen, the complete story box set, which includes the regular and director's cut of the movie, and then the motion comic. So those will be up on the store. And then, I don't know what these are, but it was like probably 50 cents for the pair, 60 cents for the pair. Seasons 1 and 2 of Molang. No idea what that is. Grab that. One more, thankfully I haven't done that lot yet, I'm doing it this weekend, of Goosebumps Horrorland. And so I'll add that to the lot before I do that this weekend. And just a few more other books for the store, some Dr. Seuss, some newer ones, and some older ones. Got those. Amanda found a few more VHS. We have a ton of VHS up on the store right now. We normally sell them pretty well, but I've just been finding so much the last couple of weeks. Even watching my video, you've seen like how many I've picked up. So there's more VHS on the store right now than we've ever had. But it'll eventually sell down. So it's really old Woody Woodpecker design. And a series of three that will put together these, the Beginner's Bible animated series. So we'll just stick those together. And then a whole bunch more books and some odds and ends and things for the store. Some more Star Wars, more modern Star Wars. Like, we have the older Timothy Zahn books and really enjoy them, but yeah. Don't really care about any of the newer stuff, the reimagining kind of stuff. Janet Ivanovich, Mercer Mayer, some Elizabeth Peters, Stephen King. And a whole bunch of odds and ends of ones that, like, Junior B. Jones, I Survived, ones that we, those kind of kids' book ones that we hold on to until we have, like, have a lot. Some more I can read. A whole bunch of these, one of the Resident Evil novelizations, number 5, about the Resident Evil Nemesis. Mercedes Lackey, I think we own this one, actually. I think Amanda had that one, so that's definitely for the store. Embrace the Night. Though this one's for us. It's one more thing for us, Sarah Douglas, because Amanda really, really likes this series. And I don't know if book 6, I think we have like 1 through 5 or something like that. So that one's actually for us. A couple more books here, dealing with dragons. Nicholas Sparks. There's more there. And then a couple odd and end things that Mana just kind of picked up. One of these Leapfrog Leapster games. And a few Pez. These are the kind of things that, you know, hold on to a bunch of them. And when you have a bunch that go together by theme, you know, comic book characters, whatever, we'll just put up a lot of any of these open ones. Or Ahsoka there. It looks like the Clone Wars Ahsoka. So there we go. That was both of us in one day. So that's really, really good. We went to a bunch of different places. I mean, just the stuff for the store I'd be happy with. But finding all that Star Trek and getting some StarGate and things, that made for an amazing day. That was fantastic. A couple Wii U games. So a really good trip. And yeah, thank you for joining me. And I will see you again shortly, because I have a couple more videos that will be going up before the end of this coming weekend. So I'll see you and have a great rest of your day.